mosquitoes are like the, you know, the most like terrifying organism on Earth, just because of the different pathogens that they can transmit to humans, but also other animals. So it's really important to have like, you know, good understanding of mosquito biology and ecology to develop new tools for mosquito control.
And so the problem we have right now is that we have a rising level of insecticide resistance that occur in mosquito populations. And in addition to that, it's increasingly evident that beyond, you know, insecticide resistance, mosquitoes are developing this physiological and behavioral resistance. You know, in Africa, to fight against malaria transmission, we've deployed bed nets that are treated with our insecticides. But the problem is that these nocturnal mosquitoes that are transmitting the pathogen responsible for malaria are now getting around this control strategy. And now they're becoming active at other times of the day. So surprisingly, we have, you know, only a limited understanding on how they can do that. And so, for example, you know, most of what we do is quantifying the behavior. So we observe mosquitoes either in a virtual flight reality, reality environment or flight simulators. So we quantify the behavior there. But then we have also the ability to look at the neural circuits. So, you know, measure the electrical activity of neurons in the brain of a mosquito that's flying. So we can see live what they think about the cues that we release.
We have live mosquitoes that we put to sleep on ice under the microscope for sure. You don't see anything otherwise. And then what we do is basically a craniotomy. We open the skull of the mosquito. So the mosquito is still alive, and we just expose different parts of the brain. We just send the mosquito antennae some different molecules that we want to test, and then we observe how the brain basically is responding. It's very small. It has to, like, don't drink coffee basically before doing that experiment, because you don't want to be like very steady.
And the overall idea is that if we understand how they do what they do and what makes them so good at finding us and biting us, we can identify levers basically to manipulate their behavior and prevent them from finding us and biting us.